In this video, we would see what is inode, what are hard link and soft link, what is the difference between hard link and soft link, and what are the use cases of hard link and soft link. Let us start. When we create a file or directory in Linux, in addition to the name and data, we also have metadata. So the metadata includes the size of the file or directory, the permissions on the file and directory, the access time or modified time of the file and directory, and the ownership information like user ID and group ID, etc. So this metadata will be stored inside a data structure called inode. Inode is also known as index node. So that contains all the metadata of a file and directory in a file system. In addition to the metadata, this inode will contain the pointer to the actual data, or it will contain pointer to another pointer which indirectly points to the actual data. So this diagram shows the directory file, inode table, and the data blocks in the file system. When we create a file, an inode number is assigned to that file, and the entry of the file, including the inode number, is present in the directory file of the corresponding directory. So this inode number will point to the actual inode information of the inode table. So this inode table will contain all the inode entries of all the files and directories in that file system. So each inode entry here represents this kind of data structure. So when we try to access a file here, so first of all, Linux will read the directory file, and it will identify the name of the file, and it will fetch the corresponding inode number, and it will read this inode table. So using this inode information, it will fetch all the metadata as well as the actual data by using the pointer address. So this way we can read a file in a file system. Similarly, write operation also will be performed in the same way. So similar to this file one, we also can create number of files. Each will be having corresponding inode number, and each will be having an entry in the inode table. So this way, inode is an important data structure in Linux file system. If it is corrupted, we cannot access the files or directories inside Linux. Now let us see some of the commands in Linux using which we can get some information about this inodes. When we create a file system in Linux, we can get the file system information using df-h command. Now if we want to get the inode information also, we have to use -i option to this command. Here we can see the number of inodes are allocated to each file system, and out of them how many inodes are used, and how many inodes are free, and what percentage of inodes are used. Here for example, for this file system, we have 512k number of inodes, and out of them we have only 310 in use, and these are all free, and only 1% of inodes are used. So this inodes indicate the maximum number of inodes allocated to each of the file systems. So if we reach this limit, for example, if we create more files and if we are reaching this limit, then we'll get disk space issues. So we'll get disk space issues not only when the disk is full, and also when the number of inodes usage is reaching the limit. So we should be careful while using these inodes. So in addition to the file system, we also can see the inode information of each file and directory using ls-li. So if I give I option here, we can see all the inode information. So from this output, we can see this is the inode number of this file, and this is the inode number for this directory. So for each file we create, an inode number will be created. So in addition to this inode number, we also can see all the metadata, and this metadata will be stored in the inode of the inode table. So this is about inode. Now let us try to understand what is a hard link and soft link. Hard link and soft link are the special files in the Linux file system. Those will point to another file or directory. For example, if I create a file here, so this will be having its own inode and corresponding data. So if I create a hard link for this file, so this hard link will be using the same inode as the original file. So this means if I delete the original file, this data will not be deleted because this inode will be used by this hard link. So using this hard link, we can create number of files. Those will use the same inode. That means all will contain the same data. If any update to any of the files happens, all other files will be updated as well, because all will be using the same inode. So now coming to soft link, when we create a soft link, it will create a new inode for this soft link. That means it will not be using the same inode of the original file. And this inode information will contain a pointer to the file one. So that means this will not contain the pointer to the actual data of the file 1. Since we are having two inodes here, if I delete the file 1, and this data will be deleted. And this soft link will not be useful at all because it is pointing to the file 1 instead of the data. Let us try to see this using Linux commands. So here we have an example 7 directory. In this directory, I'll try to create an example file, file 1. So I'll put a hi message in that file. So now file 1 is created. Now we can see that a inode number is assigned to that file. So now let us create a hard link for this file, file 1. So that will be done using ln command. Ln, we have to give the original file here. The original file is file 1 and the new file. So I will give file 1 hard link. So now using ls command, we can see that this is the file created as a new file and that file will be having the same inode number as the file 1. Now let us try to update this file 1 hard link. So I will use vi command. So I will also place hello. So now let us verify the content of the file 1 as well. So now we can see that file 1 is also having hi and hello. So now we have created a hard link for file 1. We can also create a soft link using the same command, but with option hyphen s. So we have to provide option s here and we have to mention the source file. Source file is file 1 and the target file is file 1 soft link. Let us try to find the inode information for this file. So from the output we can see that file 1 and file 1 soft link are having different inode numbers. And also the soft link is a pointer to the file 1. That means if you delete the file 1, this soft link will not be usable because that is not having the content. Actually, it is a pointer. So now let us try to delete the file 1 and we'll verify what is the content of hard link and soft link. So now we have deleted the file. Let us try to get the inode information. If we verify the content of this hard link, we can have the same content because it is pointing to the same inode of the file 1. Even the file 1 is deleted, this inode is not deleted, that's why the content is not deleted. Now since soft link is pointing to the file 1, so since file 1 is deleted, so there is no use of this soft link. If we verify file 1 soft link, so from the output we see that the file 1 soft link, no file or directory because the original file is deleted. Now we understood that what is a soft link and hard link. We also have seen what is the basic difference between soft link and hard link. Let us try to find some use case. So generally soft link will be used when we have multiple versions of a software. For example, here I have two versions of Apache Maven, 3.8.5 and 3.8.6. So now if I want to use 3.8.5, all my environment variables and if I have any scripts, all the scripts should point to this version. For example, here I am using the path variable to point to 3.8.5. And if I see the Maven version, now the Maven home points to 3.8.5. Now if I want to upgrade the Maven software with 3.8.6, I need to change all my environment variables for this 3.8.6. For example, here I am changing my path. So let me point to 3.8.6. So I will get the version of the Maven. Now the Maven home is pointing to 3.8.6. So generally when we have like multiple versions of a software and if you want to upgrade the softwares, so this way we have to change all the environment variables as well as we have to change all the scripts pointing to corresponding paths. So now to avoid this, we can create a soft link and we can use that soft link path in all the scripts and environment variables. So let us try to create a soft link. ln-s. So now for 3.8.5, I am creating a soft link. A soft link is created, we can verify that soft link. Now we can see that Maven is pointing to Apache Maven 3.8.5. So now instead of this Apache Maven 3.8.5, I will use this Maven path in the path variable. So I will change my path variable now. So now I have changed the path variable to point to soft link instead of the actual directory. So let us verify with Maven version here now. Now we can see that the Maven home is our soft link path. The version is 3.8.5. So now if we want to upgrade the software from 3.8.5 to 3.8.6, what I will do, I will delete the soft link. I'll recreate a soft link. So ln-s and I will give Maven. So if I give like this, now my Maven is pointing to 3.8.6 instead of 3.8.5. So now we do not need to change any environment variables or any scripts because we are using the path of Maven instead of the actual software path. So let us try to again verify Maven version without changing any of the path variable. So now we can see that it is pointing to 3.8.6 and the Maven home is same. So this is one of the basic use cases of soft link. And also soft links can be used when we have like multiple file systems. That means if you have a directory in an NFS file system, and we can refer that using the normal path in the current file system. So similar to soft links, we also can use hard links when we backup the files. So when we have like large files and we want to maintain multiple copies of the same files, instead of copying them, we can create hard links. Since those hard links will point to the same inode, so we will not copy the actual content. So that way we can avoid lot of time copying those large files. So there may be like multiple use cases for hard links and soft links. So these are one of the use cases of hard link and soft link. So there may be multiple use cases. If you find any use cases, please comment in the comment section. I hope this video is useful to you. Thanks a lot for watching.